so loved the world that he gave his only son. God chooses to love. He initiates love. He does not react to love. He loves first. As John wrote, we love him because he first loved us. We didn't earn the coming of Jesus Christ. We didn't deserve the death of God's Son on the cross. We didn't qualify ourselves to be recipients of God's kindness, love, and mercy. No, God chose to love us, and he continues to choose to love us. The good news about God's love is that there is nothing you can do to make God unlove you. So many Christians seem to think that when they sin and are fall short of God's plan for their lives, they disappoint God and he ceases to love them. No, the fact is, there is nothing you have ever done to deserve God's love. No amount of good works, kindness, perfect personality, or charitable deeds can win God's love. God chooses to love. He loves because he is loving. As John wrote, God is love. It is God's nature to love, and his nature does not change or alter according to human behavior. Since there is nothing that you have done or ever could do to earn God's love, there is nothing you can ever do to stop God from loving you, not even for a moment. His love for you is everlasting. When God created you, he loves you. God does not create what God does not love. Everything that God created was perceived by God to be good, perfect, whole, valuable, lovable. God doesn't make junk. He doesn't make messes. God creates what he considers to be worthy of his love, his tender care, and his eternal presence. God pours out his spirit on what he loves. He is transforming you into the likeness of Jesus Christ. And he's doing so with tender and infinite love for you. God is fashioning you and molding you and chiseling you to be his beloved child. God loves what God makes, including you. As we fully receive and abide in God's love, we are to be vessels for God's love to be poured out to others. Loving others is not just a nice idea. It is a commandment of God. Jesus said, "This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. If we abide in God's love, and are always seeking to express God's love to others, we will experience even more of God's love in our lives. If you truly desire to feel more of God's love and to grow in your love relationship with God, receive God's love openly. Choose to abide in God's love daily and seek always as many ways as possible to show God's love to others. Disciples in action, please pray this intention 3 times. Lord, help me be a vessel of, Lord, help me be a vessel for your love to be poured out to others. Please. Lord, help me be a vessel for your love to be poured out to others. Lord, help me be a vessel for your love to be poured out to others.